Stop what you are doing. Your credit cards, cue the fire. They are on fire. And I think the elites have a game plan. U.S. household debt.
That's you.
Well, unless you're not in the U.S. But I'm pretty sure that's like just about everyone in the entire world. Household debt. I know that doesn't say that. Hold on. I'll get to it. Increased $1 trillion. Pop the confetti. This is the most in 12 months after they just gave you $10 trillion and you blew it all on the stock market and gone. But this is the most since 2007. Remember the good old days? Well, until after that, then it wasn't so good. And also, I'd like to apologize for the, I don't know if this is fashionable, if you can wear the vest with the t-shirt. I don't think so. So I apologize, fashion police. Do not come after me, but it hides the dad bod. And let me change that story for you. I'll tell you that. The Fed's like, you're in trouble. I'll hold that to the end. Household debt jumped by $1 trillion in 2021, the most since 2007. Now, this is what I think is in store. And it's the same store that they gave us in 2007. Watch this. You know what? Everyone can have a house, right? Here, you get a house and you get a house. And people are like, wow, I can afford this? Yes, don't worry about your credit. Don't worry about your income, because they knew. Blow this thing up, buy it all back at the bottom. And I had articles about this. I just didn't want to go digging, but that's what they did. They knew. Here, you have a house? Oh, 1%? Oh, adjustable? Don't worry about it. They knew rates are going to go up. Do you know that rates are going to go up? I know rates are going to go up, but do you know rates are going to go up? How about 11 rate hikes? I'll get to that in just a moment. That's what your bank just said. So in 07, 08, everyone gets a house, and then in 09, everyone loses a house. And then, hey, where did these assets go? Mike Maloney actually describes it very well, but there's a correction. Wealth never poof disappears, which I would strongly disagree with them. It just transfers like a house, right? The house still stays there. Oh, it goes to someone who's smarter than you. They get the house. But now when it comes to stock market wealth, which they gave you, or $10 trillion, here, PPP, everyone gets loans. Everyone gets money. Let's put it in the stock market. Well, when those shares went from $1,000 down to $100, well, poof, gone. But please do not dissect my arguments in too much detail. I try to keep it simple. You're like, well, what about a put contract? Someone else is on the other side. They're actually making money. Yes, Douglas, but I'm trying to make it really plain and simple for the kids at home. Thank you. Oh, and hold on. Breaking news. This just into my Instagram. You guys just sent me this. This is crazy. I wish I could talk about this. Oh, there are some platforms that I can talk about it, and I will. You are now officially a, can't use that word, but we'll say a treat. You're a treat if you share misleading narratives, which sow discord or undermine public trust in U.S. government institutions. This is not a drill. Oh my gosh. So basically I go to jail if I don't share the right narrative that they would like me to share? Oh, bravo. You always just overreact. Oh my gosh. Unbelievable the times that we are living in. But I'll zoop. Whoa, where'd that key go? Sorry. Household debt. See, you guys can read in between the lines. I could squeeze some things in here. Household debt jumped by $1 trillion in 2021. How? You were just given $10 trillion. Free Pokemon cards. And some of you guys are like, I would love to have had Pokemon cards. At least that would be valuable. Like these things that the Fed gives us. Nothing. But it's okay. That's what you guys choose to use. In the fourth quarter alone, household debt grew by $333 billion to $15 trillion, the largest quarterly rate increase since 2007. And what are you spending all of this debt on? Mortgage? Oh, that'll work out really well in the end. Oh, auto loans. That's a good one. I mean, I went through the whole Rich Dad Poor Dad series, and I think this is the good investment, right? You buy this for $29,000. Oh, wait, there's a catch. Looks like they slapped on an extra $50,000 to that sticker price, right? $83,655. Well, it was It was higher, though. So you guys get out there, and you take on that new debt, and you buy that car that you just have to have, right? $100,000, fine. I'll take it. And then 3 years go down the road, it's worth like 15. And then fast forward to those 3 years, we're in this really bad recession. You're like, default. Dang it, didn't see this one coming. Oh, but the elites do. They get it. Let's do this. And then we get to buy all these things on pennies on the dollar. But I mean, don't worry, it's not they don't want your Ford Bronco. They're coming after land, your house. So what I am waiting for, right? Because we need to do this. That's what they're gonna do. I'm waiting for it. Zero interest loans, you know, la, whatever. Everyone needs to be afford a home. That's just the right that everyone has. I mean, it's not fair that all these people drive Lamborghinis. I think they should have a right to drive a Lamborghini. And gone. And here we go. Mortgage debt rises. Yeah, you think it's bad now. You just give the Fed a little more time. I just wish they did the adjustable thing, like, oh, come on in. It's 1%. Go ahead. You can have a house. You can have a house, and then the Fed cranks on the printer. And what I mean by that is the Fed funds rate, the short end. Then everyone gets confused. Fed go burr. Now, I wouldn't have a problem with all of this if we had a good economy, which we don't, because we need to make things, right? We need to have jobs and create things. It has nothing to do with the digits. It's do you have goods and services? That's what an economy is. And the answer is, ding, 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 no. U.S. posts record trade deficit in 2021, 2022, 2023, 2024. You see, China is shoving us all their junk, but now we're broke. They're slowing down. They're like, why? You don't want our junk? No, we don't want our junk. We don't produce junk. They don't produce junk. The game's starting to come to an end. But not just that. The Commerce Department said on Tuesday that the trade deficit increased almost 30% last year. All-time high. Man, we're just breaking these records. Boy, bravo, the economy grew 5.7% in 2021. Sure, give people, $10 trillion, right? Oh, look, GDP's up. Yes, that is because you have stolen, you stole it from your kids, from the future, and you used it for now. And then in the future, your kids get to pay it back in taxes. So I don't like kids anyway, so I say tax them. I think everyone under the age of 25, right? Tax rate 95%. I mean, maybe 100. It all just goes to the government. Then you're like, wow. I mean, please tax these kids. Let them feel what it's like to be adulting on the other side. And I'm sure their voting decisions would definitely change when they're like, okay, let's see. I made $100. The Fed got 40. So I got 60 bucks. All right, now the state, how much do they want? Oh, they want almost 20%. That'd be California. Gavin's coming for you. So now what are you left over with? Oh, now you're at 40 bucks? Oh, you had 100, now you're at 40. Oh, then why don't you give up one of these for property tax? Give the rest away. See, we got to hit them young. Teach them young. China falls woefully short. Come on, Brandon, what are you doing over here? Commitments to purchase U.S. goods amid Biden lack of enforcement. You see, in an economy, you need goods and services. We give you your goods, you give you our. You don't want to be imbalanced. Otherwise, it ends up really bad. But as it says here, Biden's lack of enforcement, well, when he finds out he's president, I promise he'll change things. And I swear these never get old. Brock, am I Captain America now? Yes, Joe, just don't push that little red button on your desk. Also, for those of you that are like, they're not going to raise rates at all. Okay, 1994 to 95, they priced in 125 basis points. You got 300. That was a miss. In May 1999, the good old days, party like it's 1999, expected 50, got 175. It's kind of like jumping on the scale and you're like, okay, I starved myself all week. What? It went up? Like in 2004, 2006, we're going to get 300. No, you're not. You're going to get 425. But what about 2015 and 2018? We're only going to get 150. They pinky promise. Oh, you got 225. So keep those credit cards nice and juicy for them. Bank of America is predicting 11 rate hikes this year and next. So my hope for you is you do not have your debt on things called credit cards or things with interest, because that interest is going up. You want to know what else is going up? The banks that actually charge you for that said interest. Or these banks behind me. Yeah, the Fed. Uh-huh, these guys. It's getting hot in here. We got to be talking about CPI could push Fed closer to a big rate hike. It's coming. But Bravo, look. Look up above your head. It's a bird. It's a plane. It's Jerome Powell, the chosen one. Look, the markets only go up. S&P up 1%. Russell up 1.5%. The dollar is down. But Bravo, you said the economy's bad, but the market goes up. I've said this for 1,000 years. The economy and this has no correlation. Oh my gosh, wouldn't that be nice? Look over there, the gold. See that? That's called a cup and handle. I've showed that to you many times. That's like on the weekly. If that thing ever plays out, you measure from there to there, from there way, way up there. So hopefully, I gotta get a gold bar. I'm tired of using Bravo and this is fine. Also, the reason why I go over to those charts, the reason why I teach you how to make these things, this, right? It's part of, it's called an economy. You want to be in it. I mean, even the Fed, look, the Fed, if you're a wage earner, and you cannot be a wage earner. I mean, you can. Think of that's your side hustle. Your businesses, your trades, like that should be your income. You're going to fall behind. Why is that? Because the entire thing is just musical chairs, and every day they remove a chair and the song stops and you're like, oops. I know this article, the ex-Fed insider warns of difficult few years. It's not just going to be a difficult few years. It's going to be forever. And also, since Valentine's Day is coming up, I want to give you a gift. I'm going to give you my How to Start a Business, my Dominate Amazon $1,000, my swing trading $1,000, my crypto stocks university $1,000. That would be $3,000 for $497 or $499. And if you're like, oh my gosh, but I already have I just want to help people start a business, trade equities, start a business. Look, like, and don't listen to the news, even though the news and whatever, it's all going to be like la la lies. Tell me some more. I think something slipped out, by the way. I'm guessing the CPI reading must be below the expectations. Then they slip it to the banksters and everyone makes money. And then people are just like, wait, what's going on? I say time and time again, which you guys called me crazy. You said why? And you also told me not to sing. Okay, I won't sing. When I put in a buy order right there, I do it. And I showed you on Bitcoin. I'm like, this is where I'm buying it. It was last weekend or this weekend, you know, whatever today is. I don't even know days anymore. But this weekend, before, long story, I put in a buy. You're like, you're crazy. Well, I am crazy. 100% agree. But I trade what's in front of me. This is what I see. I don't know what noise is. Noise, right here. See that little blue thing? That's where I put in a trade. That's where I said, get the frack out. I did. That's called a rising wedge. Uh-huh. That's in the CSU course. Look, I said, I even left myself a note. Dear JB, if we cross that little blue line from a rising wedge, please, please, please short the out of this mother. Okay, management. And I even drew a little blue line. Where to close my position? Thanks, Johnny Bravo. Just in case you want to know the swing trade, you're like, oh, this is old. It's easy to predict something in the past. I taught it in the past. James, Douglas, Scott, my gosh, Karen. Look at this. Here, I'll turn this on. See? There's the Bravo 9. That's the red. See? And I let my accounts run. Oh my gosh, there's more money in there now. I mean, yes, just paper trading though. Also, if you want, apologies. There is a link in the descriptions for discounts on all my courses during the V-Day. For the men, you know, since we're the ones like, oh gosh, what do you want? What do I get? Dudes are easy. My wife's like, I know what you want. I know I cannot go out and buy it. That would be correct, dear. Let me just turn on this. Have no idea, but I bet you a buy signal's going to come up. Oh, hey, look. Go quinky dink, right? Buy. So if you really, really need help with this, you turn on indicators. They're all in the course. And you just, it sounds stupid, buy and hold, but you don't buy and hold. You trade. And then you can use all that paper trading money to be hype beast like these guys. And like come fronting the Gucci's on fire. And in Texas, they call that big hat, even though he's wearing, you got the Gucci hat, Big hat, no cattle. You got nothing. You just look like you do. But I know 2022, we're going to change all this up just for you so you don't miss out on the last. Remember the last? Woo! Oh my gosh, the market went. You just wait. Wait till we have a blow off top. Oh my, I don't know where the liquidity is going to come from, but that's usually how market cycles go. And I don't want you left behind. I will see you in the next video.